Hello and welcome back to another WordPress tutorial. Today in this video you will learn how to create and design a blog post grid or a blog post list inside Elementor free version. So as you know, a blog page is an important part of a WordPress website and each theme provides a different look for the blog post. For example, this is my website. Here as you can see, these are the blog posts. So if you want, you can change the theme for a different look, or you can design a simple or a look that you want inside the free version of Elementor. So let's see how we can do this, and for this we will use our previous website which we created in the previous video. As you can see, this is a website like YouTube where you can embed your YouTube, Vimeo, Dailymotion and self-hosted videos, and the look is also just like YouTube. It also have a dark mode. So if you want to create a website like this, then you can watch my previous video. So we will create a blog post grid like this one inside Elementor free version and with the use of another free plugin. So let's see how we can create this. So this is the WordPress dashboard. Here I have installed Elementor, as you can see. And for creating and designing the blog post grid, we will use a simple free plugin which is Blog Designer for Elementor. And here, as you can see, we can create post carousel, post slider, post grid, list, mensary, standard and so on. And this is a free plugin which is very powerful. You can learn more about this plugin here. You can see the features. So we will install and activate this plugin. I already have installed this, but to install this you can just copy its name, go back to Elementor, sorry, to the dashboard, and go to plugins and click add new. And here search for that plugin. As you can see, Blog Designer for Elementor. So just install and activate this plugin. And now we will add a new page just to show you how this works. And for example, I write a title like this. I'll simply publish this page and we'll edit this with Elementor. And I'm using the Bloxy theme, so just recreate the kit. Save changes. And then refresh. And now we have a blank page where we can create and design our blog post grid. So first let me change the width to full width. And here I'll create a new section. We'll keep this the single layout and we'll give this some padding. And we will design this letter in this video. And to add the blog post grid, just go to modules and search for post. And you will see this post layouts. This is due to the plugin that we just installed. So just drag that over here. And you can see this. This is a really cool look. The color scheme is dependent on the theme, so you can change this anytime you want. Now this has two columns, we can change this to three columns, we can change the layout. So let's change this to three column. And now these are some of the settings that you can change according to your need. These are the styles, and everything is inside the free version of this plugin, which is very awesome. And here you can start designing your post. Now if you want to change the look, then you can change it right here. As you can see, the thumbnail is on the top. I can display this on the left side like this, or on the right side. We can also change the text size, then this will look good. We can also hide the categories. So let's keep that on the top. And this is mastery layout, so you can disable this also. And you can hide the title, category, category or image and so on. So these are the categories. If I want to hide this, then I can simply hide this. Let's show that again. And this is over the image. If I turn this off, then this will display below the image. And this is the read more button, so you can write your own text. This is the pagination, so if you scroll down, then this will display pagination. Now we have only 6 posts. If I change this to 3, then we got this navigation, and I can change it if I want. Like we can next and previous, we can remove the navigation and so on. Let's keep this 6. Now this is a ready made, which is also looks very nice. Now if I want to stylize this, then I can take inspiration from any layout, for example block, post, grid design. If I see the images and scroll down, and let's pick this one. So for example I like this one, then I can create something like this right here in the Elementor. So we have 3 columns, the background is this. I can pick this color and I'll edit the section, go to style, and the background type will be a color. We'll paste that color, and now let's start designing this like this one. So I'll edit the blog post again. Now everything is inside the style, so I'll go to style, and this is the box, which is this one. Let me give it a color so that you can differentiate it. For example, let's make this white. As you can see, these are the boxes. I can also give it a background image if I want, but that will not look like this. Now let's hide the categories. So again, we will hide this, go back to style, and I can give this a gradient background also. And this is the box shadow. So as you can see, we have a little bit box shadow as well. So let's click this. We'll give this a box shadow of this color. The blur will be up to 25. And this is the inner padding, which is this spacing. I can increase and decrease this like this. Okay, let's, as you can see, the spacing increases. So you can change this accordingly. Now let's scroll down. This is the item padding, which will be the spacing between each item, which is this one, sorry. And the item margin is also the spacing. And this is the border type. If you want to give this a border, then you can select a border. Text alignment is to the left. If you want to center this, then you can do it like this. Let's keep it to the left. This is the first thumbnail, which is basically the image, and you can give this some CSS filters or the border radius to this image. You can also give this hover animation, like as you can see, if I hover over here, then it the black overlay. Now let's go to post title, and the title size is a little big, so I can decrease this just like this. And I can change the font and the font family as well. For example, Poppins and bold, which look like this. Okay, now let's close this. And you can also give this title some padding and margin. You can change its color. For example, you want this color. As you can see, that's changed. And this is the first excerpt, and here, as you can see, these are the excerpt. So you can change its typography, text color, and so on. This is the post meta, but we have hide that, like the author name, the date, category, and so on. And now this is the read more button, which is this one. I can change its color and padding as well. Here we don't have the read more button, but let's make this a little short like this. Now the top and bottom padding is due to the theme, but I can decrease this. So this is how you can design this. Now the text, sorry, the text size, which is here in the typography, and this is how you can design the button. And the border radius for the button is, and this is the border radius of the button. For example, I want to keep this 5, then this will change it, which looks much better. Now, as you can see, this color is different from this one, then I can choose the button color here. Sorry, this is the color. Let's control Z and read more button. And the background color will be that one. So this is how you can design things according to your need. Now we can also design the pagination, which I just showed you. So let's decrease the first again. And now we can design this pagination as well. And we can change the background with that color. We can increase the border radius like this. And we can also give this some margin like this, as you can see. So this is how you can change the pagination. Now we don't need this, so we can simply remove that again. So as you can see, we got this look here on our blog post. If I update this and let's preview the page, then as you can see, we have a blog post grid design in the free Elementor. So this is how you can design a blog post grid inside Elementor free version. I hope the video will help you. If you have any questions, you can ask in the comment section. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.